Hello, dears, and welcome back to the channel Benidorm by Anna. Boy, we are surprised and shocked today. That's all I'm gonna say for now. We've woken up today with a lot of messages in our social media accounts, a lot of messages from people who know us. And all these messages were saying basically, check it out, you are in the local news. We didn't do anything. So we rushed into the news sections in one of the top three most popular newspapers here in Valencian community, which is 20 minutes. And there I was. Here you can see it. Our news, Benidorm update from past Friday went to the local news. And all this because we did, as usual, a situation in tourism update where we were speaking that we are hitting record amount of numbers of tourists, where we said that the type of tourism that Spain had before, which is more quantity, not quality, is changing slowly. And obviously, the statistics shown that it's not the best tourism, that Benidorm is still busy with around 90% of occupancy, some hotels, all of this that you've heard in the past news update. And all of a sudden, it was all over Spanish news. Benidorm's YouTuber Anna is stating this and this and that. And we were in shock because obviously the vast majority of things they said in the article were kind of true, but not all of it. So now I get why people say you have to check the news twice. You have to see where originally it comes from and if it's true or not. Now I know why. Obviously, it's not a yellow press. This is like a prestigious newspaper that people trust. I myself read this newspaper like every single day. I read 20 minutes. I read it because it's one of the main ones in our region for all the Valencian community and the rest of Spain too. So I love it. I do read it. And a lot of people are. But the thing is that some of the things that they said were not entirely accurate to what I said in English because it's a Spanish newspaper and they translated it. So the essence is not exactly the same. Hey, your girl is in the national / local newspaper now. I didn't even know they read us, they followed us, but obviously now they know that we exist. So we follow each other mutually. That was quite fun. And some subscribers also say that this article went up on their local news, prestigious newspapers as well, that everyone read in their local cities and towns, for example, in UK. We were absolutely shocked. Not gonna lie. Today, we're giving you some more situation update and we have two news and useful information for you to enjoy your holidays even more here in Benidorm, Costa Blanca, or even Spain. First of all, let's talk as usual about the tourism situation. And in this case, we're bringing you some information about the upcoming events. Once again, you all know it's busy. We've talked about it in the past news update, so no need to reconfirm it once again. It's still busy, so it's definitely not going to be lonely or empty if you arrive on holidays right now, even in October month. So we have some interesting celebrations coming up. First of all, it's Halloween preparation time. Many cities started to prepare for that, but meanwhile, we still have November fiestas in Benidorm that will be happening here for 1 week, slightly more than 1 week. Epic celebrations, parades, celebrations on the streets, crafts markets, fairs, and much, much more on November fiesta in Benidorm. You need to visit it if you will be here in the area. Roasted chestnuts, typical Spanish turrón, caramelized apples, walnuts, nuts, almonds. So many things will be available for you during your holidays here in November month. Meanwhile, before November, we have Halloween coming up. I know there are some people who are fans, those who are not so much, but those who are, at least just to wander around and see how people are dressed up for Halloween. This is a fun activity that we personally made as our own tradition. Every 31st of October, we're heading to Benidorm when we're filming a video for you guys on Halloween theme, just for us to show you how many candies are being given inside of the town, because a lot of businesses participate in it. How many costumes are on the streets? What's going on and what's the atmosphere? So this year is going to be no exception. For Halloween, Terra Natura, Mundomar, Terra Mitica, like all these theme parks, excluding Aqualandia because it's closed, it will be closed. All these parks do offer Halloween themed activities, and some of them are from 26th to 27th of October, and then first days of November is when you have themed activities, and it's all dressed up like Halloween, all decorated nicely and spooky. So it's fun if you have children or if you by yourself love these type of themed holidays. Obviously, there is going to be also face painting. This makeup crafts event will be held from 21st to 25th of October in the evenings, between 8 in the evening and 10 in the evening. It is true that it has a price of 10 euros, but there's going to be a professional makeup artist there that you will be able to join and recreate different types of makeups, even if it's just for fun, you know. Even if it's just to have some nice way of spending the evening, get to know how to make new things. Maybe for your children, grandchildren, for yourself, they'll be showing you how to apply fake blood, even like fake parts of the face, different typical makeup, like spooky makeup for Halloween. It's quite a nice craft place. And if you're interested, you're able to join. No need to write down or register beforehand. Just be there on that date between 8 and 10 p.m. Apart from that, a lot of clubs, nightclubs will be celebrating Halloween nights. So it's going to be really, really busy. There's going to be a lot of costumes at nighttime in Benidorm as well. There is El Prado on the streets, El Prado Museum art exhibition. Not a real one, obviously, but pictures in real size. It is quite interesting, I dare to say. We've been to the Mediterranean Avenue. We'll show it to you shortly. It's going to be here a whole month of October with some theatrical rehearsals and expositions, weekends in the evenings during the whole month of October. And it's great because it gives you some special things to do during your holidays if you're seeking for more cultural events. Apart from that, gaming contest, there's going to be theater, micro theater, and much, much more available for you here in the months of October and November. Let's continue with the second news today, and it is about markets. Who does not love a good market when they're coming on holidays? Go early in the morning with your small bag, explore, buy some nice souvenirs, try out typical Spanish food, maybe bring some accessories or clothes here from Spain, shoes made in Spain, also quite popular, I'm gonna say. Try out typical Spanish food, get a freshly pressed orange juice, churros with chocolate, and much more. All of this is available on local markets. They are more or less the same, but with some differences in terms of pricing and available dates, which is why today in this Benidorm News update, we've decided to give you dates when local markets are open and how to get there, plus the map of its exact location. So click a like and subscribe if you like this type of information here on the channel, which I suppose is going to be useful for a lot of you. First of all, Benidorm's markets. Benidorm town has two different markets, plus the flea and antiques market, El Cisne. The El Cisne market is open Thursdays, Fridays, and Sundays. Sunday and Thursday are the busiest days. They have shows of flamenco. They have paella. It's an ideal place just to stay there the whole entire day and explore different old things, vintage things, something that you wouldn't even think you would find on the market might be there. This market is easy to access with the bus number 10 from the city center of Benidorm going towards Alfaz del Pi and Altea. Stops right next to it, next to the campsite of Benisol. The next ones are markets that are not flea or antique ones, but just like a regular market combining food and accessories and souvenirs and a little bit of everything, I must say. And this is the famous Rincon de Loich Sundays and Wednesdays market situated by the Hotel Pueblo Benidorm as you can see here on the map, obviously. This market is great if you're staying somewhere nearby. This is a typical touristic market. You can find souvenirs, clothing, accessories, churros with chocolate, typical Spanish nuts, walnuts, caramelized apples and sweets, pastries, freshly pressed orange juice, and much, much more. Plus seasonal fruit and veggies as well. If you're staying for a longer time and you're in self-catering, that's an ideal place where to go. And this market is Wednesday and Sunday, usually open from 8 in the morning, more or less, up until 2 p.m. approximately. This market has easy access from Rincon de Loich. Any kind of bus that stops on Rincon de Loich, you can take it or even come walking. Another market that is called Municipal Market of Benidorm is situated right next to the tram station on the upper part of Benidorm town. And here, once again, is the map of its location, right next to the Folletes Park. This place is open only on Wednesdays, so that's the only day. In summertime, this market moves towards Plaza de Toros of Benidorm, and this is during festivals time, and then it goes back to its usual location. In Cala of Finestrat, great place, we've been there, we've filmed it for you guys. It is between Villajoyosa and Benidorm's town. Gorgeous place, quiet beach, nice restaurants as well. And right here we have a market right by the seashore, right by the beach, on Tuesdays and Saturdays. Same opening hours. Usually all markets open up from around 8 in the morning up until 2 to 30, Tuesdays and Saturdays. This market is cheaper than the one in Benidorm in Rincon de Loich. Then we have Albir's market, our village's market, which is open every Sunday. Same opening hours. You can get the bus number 10 from Benidorm or from Alfaz and Altea. Bus number 10, stop right on the main avenue. You will see a huge parking lot with a lot of sellers. That is the municipal market of Albir. And it is the most expensive one officially of all this region. Sundays, if you're interested. In Alfaz del Pi, on Friday, we have a market. It's situated right next to the supermarket, bus number 10 as well. If you're coming from Benidorm, immediately after the municipal library and the health center, immediately after the big roundabout, it's going to be the next stop. This is also one of the cheaper markets. It might be compared to the one in La Cala Finestrat and to Altea's market as well. Friday, early morning, available. In Altea, we have the market on Tuesdays. This is the market that is kind of split. It was before split in two parts. Now, at least in summer, it was only in one side, but I do suspect that in winter they will split it back again. Maybe. Maybe that's not going to be the case. It is situated next to the old town of Altea at the bottom part of it. And it's also a great market, but I find that they're lacking pastry and freshly baked bread. That's what they're lacking. They don't have any kind of bread shop that would be selling there. They have churros, yes. They have a cafeteria, yes, but not freshly baked like bread and pastries, croissants, something to bring typical back home for breakfast. They did not have that last time when we visited. So this was the only thing that we were lacking. But price-wise, absolutely great. To a lot of these places, Altea also bus number 10 up until the last stop. And from there, it's literally 100 meters maybe from the last stop in Altea towards this market. In terms of how can you pay? The vast majority already right now are accepting cards and cash payments. So you don't need to worry about it. Both of them are acceptable. Some might ask cash, but you have ATM machines nearby. Can you bargain? Yes, and you should try it out because it's quite fun, I'm going to say. You can bargain everything that is not food related. And now let's continue with the last news that I wanted to share with you all. And it is something that some people did ask us on social media on our Instagram account, which is the same as here, Benidorm by Anne. If you're not following us there, follow us. We are planning on posting plenty more shorts, short videos,
stories, reels, and much, much more out there. And each time, whenever you want to see which new video has been posted on YouTube, if you don't have time right now, but you want to see if there's something new, on our Instagram, we have all the previews of the videos as well. And some people did ask us what is happening with the all-inclusive. Did they restrict the drinks for only 3 drinks? And I suppose it is because in some parts of Spain, mostly Balearic Islands, it was mostly the island areas of Spain, for years and years in a row, people were speaking about restricting the all-inclusive due to a lot of people being drunk and then causing issues in specific areas, okay, of holidays, not in all of them. On all-inclusive, and they were limiting alcohol drinks, in general drinks, for slightly less, like limited. Although it's all-inclusive, they were trying to limit the drinks. And people were asking if it's the same here in Benidorm, what is going on, did we hear any news about it or not. We did check every single newspaper, we did check it online as well, on online newspapers that we have here, which are the same ones as on paper, and we did not see anything related with recent changes as for how much drinks are you allowed to take on the all-inclusive. I will say, however, that in our region, at least in Benidorm town, less and less hotels offer all-inclusive. It is not profitable any longer. It is a type of tourism that less and less hotels prefer right now, and they've seen that there's been a huge shift in what people are looking for. Yes, if you're coming with children, you might fancy more an all-inclusive hotel, but a lot of families still do prefer, the most popular options are half board or full board. Self-catering slightly less, unless you're taking an Airbnb or a touristic apartment, then that's the case. And there is no need, in specific areas, there is no need of it. In Mallorca, we still see quite a lot of all-inclusive ones, in Menorca as well. In Canary Islands, mostly the islands, we do see quite a lot of all-inclusive. It all depends on the area, but no specific restrictions whatsoever that we know of that we should let you know. No recent changes in terms of all-inclusive, nothing like that has happened. So I definitely feel like, once again, as we've started today's video, newspapers, a lot of the times they are just giving more than it is and making the appearance that it is more serious than it actually is, or interpreting wrong something said in Spanish and translating it, or just trying to scare people away so that they wouldn't go and spend money elsewhere but spend it in your own country instead. You know, there's might be many motives, there might be many things, but definitely no major changes happening with the all-inclusive here whatsoever. So don't worry, those who are traveling on all-inclusive, you will still be able to enjoy it. Let's talk about the weather today. As for the day of today, it was sunny in the morning, but now when it's midday / towards early afternoon time, the clouds started to come to the region. I don't think it's going to be raining. And according to the local Spanish meteorology organization, which is IMET, National Meteorological Agency, it's called. There's going to be quite unstable timing here throughout all entire week, in general in all Spain. Central parts of Spain will have quite a lot of rain, as you can see. And here, more or less, it should be sunny with just a tiny bit of clouds. From Wednesday, it is going to be raining almost in whole entire Spain, with an exception of the Mediterranean area. As you can see, we are always really, really lucky because we're protected by mountains. If it wouldn't be the case, here it would be raining as in all other parts of Spain, trust me. So we might have some rain here after these days. Some more rain will come from south parts towards Mediterranean side and central parts of Spain. And this is when, this upcoming weekend, it might rain a bit. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, more or less, it might rain, but it's not confirmed just yet because you never know. There's still plenty of time to wait up until the weekend. We'll see how it goes. Even if it will be raining, temperatures will not drop too much. Today was around 26 to 27 maximum temperatures, and these type of temperatures will be here the whole entire week. So it's still quite cozy, quite warm. We are walking like this with light summer t-shirts or blouses. I'm sure how you can call it. It's a blouse, probably. Yeah, probably it is a blouse. So we're walking still with summer clothing. We use kind of quite open shoes. We don't have jackets unless it's evening time or something to cover shoulders and the arms, or like maybe light scarf. That is that. There's still a gorgeous weather. Now it's slightly windy, but it wasn't the case earlier in the morning. So you will still be able to enjoy. Don't worry, even if you come right now in October. Remembering last year, the Halloween night, we did not even need jackets when we went to Benidorm. So this is how warm it actually was. Thank you for accompanying us on today's Benidorm News Update. We wish you great holidays if you are on one, or will be shortly. And we'll see you here on the channel once again tomorrow with a brand new video. Episode 2 of The Silent Walks. Which street or which city is it going to be tomorrow? You will find out shortly. Don't forget to click a like and subscribe to our channel if you still did not do so. This is very important for YouTube algorithms to push us forward, to show us to more and more audience each time that might be interested in Benidorm, Costa Blanca, and Spain. Ideas.